New at 4 now, police investigating the latest attack on an anti-violence activist in the city's Englewood neighborhood.
But this man did survive the shooting, and he's telling his story to WGN. Let's go to Dana Rebick. She's live in Englewood now with the story. Dana.
We just got finished speaking with this young man a short time ago after he was discharged from Stroger. Now, about 2 months ago, he attended a vigil for one of his best friends who was murdered. And at that event, this young man was wearing a T-shirt on it that read, "Who's next?" He never thought it would be him.
Yeah, when my time. I mean, that just means to me I have a purpose.
It's been a little more than 24 hours since Jermaine Kelly was shot.
It went in and came out.
Around 6:15 yesterday morning, the Englewood resident, who is also a volunteer with the group MASK, Mothers Against Senseless Killings, was waiting to drive two of his friends to school, standing near his car in the 7400 block of South Vincennes, when he heard shots and realized he had been hit in the hand and thigh.
And I couldn't walk right. And like I said, I had a good friend that he seen where it came from. He helped me press on. He took me immediately right to the hospital.
This summer, two mothers, Chantel Grant and Andrea Stoudemire, who volunteered for MASK, were shot and killed on this very corner. A week later, one of Kelly's childhood friends and fellow volunteer was murdered. Despite the violence, this trade school student, hoping to be an electrician, is pushing on.
Don't give up. Don't give up hope. Don't stop grinding. Like, you gotta stay focused and stay committed to what you know. And your better. Chase after your better or your best. And now that I'm at that place in my life that I know what my better is, this makes me want to get to it even more.
We'll have much more with Jermaine Kelly coming up on our news at 5:30. So far, Chicago police have not made any arrests in this case. Live at the 6th Police District, Dana Rebick, WGN News.